Ah, the great outdoors. It used to be that we humans would head to the wilderness for a break from civilization. Of course, that was before we felt the need to instantly post pictures of every deer or waterfall we see. The problem with us trying to channel Ansel Adams with our smartphones is that there's no place to plug in our devices on the side of a mountain. Now, one innovator has come up with a way to help keep you connected while you connect with nature. The days of panicking over a low battery signal while on location or vacation in nature may be long over thanks to this man and his team. Andrew Cook is one of the co-inventors of this little guy. They call it the WaterLily Turbine. Andrew Cook told me all about it from his headquarters in Newfoundland, Canada. Hello, Andrew, and welcome to our show.
Hi, Mo. Thanks for having me.
What sparked the idea for your turbine?
So we originally built the turbines that were about 1 to 2 feet in diameter to power devices that were measuring ocean parameters for things like climate change, global warming, for scientists and engineers that were just gathering information in the oceans in general. And one of the big things is that all that equipment was battery powered, and changing batteries of equipment that's, you know, 200 miles offshore in the ocean is a really difficult task. And we knew that outdoor enthusiasts were also facing similar issues with their battery-powered cell phones and GPSs. So we knew we could shrink down the same technology to about 6 inches in diameter and provide outdoor enthusiasts with the same sort of features as the big turbines.
How does it work?
It works just like a regular wind turbine. It spins with the flow of the river, or if you put it in the wind, and that rotational energy is converted into electrical energy, which then passes out through a USB port into your cell phone or your GPS device.
Inside the turbine is what's called a magnet generator. Spinning magnets pass by coils, which induces an electrical current. That's how the kinetic energy created by the spinning rotors gets converted into electrical energy to power those smart devices. And as long as there's water or wind, the turbine will continue to charge. No sun or other devices needed. Thank you for joining us on Innovation Nation.
Thank you, Mo.